Did you see yesterday TAP 138,000 page views?
Betsy is incredible in her role as a leader at the Journal Sentinel. Obviously, that's a very time-sensitive, time-oriented position to be in. News just comes as it comes, and she's passionate about all that it takes to have a first-class newspaper.
This is a local paper that has won 3 Pulitzers in the last 4 years. That's extraordinary. In a time when local papers are struggling all over the country, our paper is thriving.
We're here on the 4th floor of the Journal Building, the news hub of Milwaukee and probably all of North America.
We're thrilled about the Pulitzer Prizes that we've won. Only the New York Times and the Washington Post has won more Pulitzer Prizes than the Journal Sentinel during that period. And Betsy's as excited about it as anybody in this newsroom.
I am so proud of the work done by all the professionals at the Journal Sentinel. No matter which department, news, sales, production, circulation, back office, all of them have been so talented and so accomplished and have great work ahead of them. And if I've had a role in sharing that in any way, I am incredibly proud of their accomplishments.
At her core, at her heart, she's a storyteller and a newswoman. She happens to have outstanding business acumen, so she brings the whole package.
She's worked for the finest newspapers in this country. Starting out as a reporter at the Chicago Tribune, she's worked at the New York Times, she's been in Seattle, she's been in Miami, and now she leads our Journal Sentinel. It's phenomenal.
What's great for me as editor is that she started her career as a reporter and a columnist. So she understands the mission of the newsroom. And sometimes when we're writing about controversial topics, it can be tough for publishers, but it's not tough for her.
The media world is changing, and that's no surprise because there are so many different choices out there for readers, for advertisers, for viewers, and trying to deal with that change, trying to help our people manage through that change has been tremendously challenging.
She's on the board of directors for the Associated Press. And so that gives her a nice view of what else is happening out there.
Preserving freedom of the press, access, security, and making sure AP can evolve into a digital future is what board members do. And it's been incredibly fulfilling.
Her leadership is exponential. It just doesn't stay in the publishing or newspaper business. It goes wherever she goes.
She's on our board of trustees at Children's Hospital, and when we formed a new committee called the Advocacy Committee, we went right to Betsy to ask her to chair that committee on behalf of the board of trustees. And Betsy has gone to Washington, D.C. with me to talk to the elected officials and really positions herself very well to be very knowledgeable, passionate, and enthusiastic, and they listen to her.
I also serve as one of the 2 co-chairs of United Way's Teen Pregnancy Prevention Oversight Committee. We have a very ambitious goal of reducing teen pregnancy in our community by 43% by 2015, and we are well on our way to accomplishing that with 3 consecutive years of seeing a reduction in the rate of teen births.
And no matter how daunting or no matter how difficult the task at hand was, I could always get a whisper across the desk, "Can you believe we're doing this?" And I think that was what I remember most, and that's the thing that I love most about working with Betsy Brenner.
In 2003, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. It was a very important, I think, change in my life because I learned that I can't do everything all the time. I can't fix everything all the time. I had to trust other people to do that for me, and I am so grateful they were there.
There was a time in Betsy and Steve's life where they were called upon to do what I would consider something very incredible. They had a housekeeper who worked for them for many years. She suddenly died. They were asked to raise these 2 children, and they've done it, and they've done it very successfully.
She's a good friend, one who understood in the most dramatic way an adoption is giving of oneself and giving the gift of life to another.
Betsy is an avid cyclist. as is Steve, her husband. Betsy gets out there and boy, she just tears up the street.
And that is my way to relax, and it's a lot of fun. I'm just very lucky, and very lucky and to be in a position to work with great people, give back to a community, and be part of a place as great as Milwaukee.
This award is emblematic of someone who has no fear and will have their legacy be, we helped change a city. So this is great.
Betsy, I want to congratulate you for this awesome award. I can't think of a more deserving individual.
You are a wonderful, wonderful person to work with and learn from, and Milwaukee is so very, very lucky to have you as part of this community.
This award suggests to everyone that you are the type of leader that can transform Milwaukee, transform Wisconsin, and transform this nation.
Congratulations, Betsy. We're so proud of you for this award. It's really tremendous. Congratulations.